the first of our quarterfinals complete. Next up is mixed doubles, and it features the reigning world and Olympic champions, Tuntui Ahmad and Liliana Nasir. They're up against the Malaysian pair, the number 8 seeds, the Tan Kieng Meng and Lai Pei Jing. Well, as far as the mixed doubles draw is concerned, by quarterfinal stage, we were down to 5 seeds. 4 in the bottom half of the draw, but only 1 in the top half, and that's the defending champions, Cheng Shiwei and Cheng Qingcheng. They're in a real battle at the moment, with the pair promoted from the qualifying, Ben Lane and Jessica Pugh. So, only 1 seed in the top half of the draw, and in the bottom half of the draw, all 4 seeds that started that bottom half. 5 different nations involved, 3 Chinese pairs. So the countdown clock for the players to enter the Stade de Coubertin. Here they come. Led out by the Malaysians. A welcome return to form for the Malaysians, Tan Kieng Meng and Lai Pei Jing. Lost in the first round of their last 2 Super Series prior to this, and prior to those 2 first round losses, lost in the second round of the 2 Super Series prior to that. Well, the world and Olympic champions, Tuntui Ahmad and Liliana Nasir, number 4 seeds here, and former champions here. That was 3 years ago when they beat Chris and Gabby
Adcock. Yes, and who will receive?
In the final. The Adcocks, incidentally, were the number 5 seeds this year and withdrew, injured before play got underway. A change of ends before the warm-up period starts. So these 2 pairs, Malaysia and Indonesia. It was an amazing pair that was beaten by the Indonesians in the Olympic final, but it wasn't this pair. Tan Kieng Meng is 23 years of age, born in Johor Bahru, Malaysia's 2nd largest city. He's a tall athlete, isn't he? 185, that's about 6'1". His partner, Lai Pei Jing, is 25 years of age, from Kuantan in Pahang. Lives now in Kuala Lumpur, trains at the National Training Center. And they, as you can see, have been as high as 9 in the world ranking. A total of 21 weeks as world number ones, but they actually went down 1 place in the world ranking yesterday, down to a number 11. And they've had their battles here in the first round against Huapet and Kili Harakun of Thailand. It was a tight opening game. And then yesterday against the home favourites, Ronon Labar and Audrey Fontaine. Dropped the opening game, but came back 21-11 in the deciding game. I enjoyed that one. I was sitting watching that. So to Tuntui Ahmad, the number 4 seed, they've gone up 1 place in the world ranking this week to number 3. They have been as high as 2. A total of 101 weeks as world number 2s. Winners, as I say, in 2014. They were semi-finalists here in 2011. Now, Liliana Nasir, she's won this title twice, because she also won the mixed doubles title here in 2009 with Nova Widianto. Beat Hendra Aprida Gudumun and Vita Marissa in that final. So the 32-year-old from Manado, very experienced, and you can see that yesterday against Ivan Sutunov and Evgenia Kosetskaya went the full distance, dropped the middle game there, having beaten Pranav Jerry Chopra and Siki Reddy in the first round. Incidentally, both their previous opponents consisting of a left and right hander. So this will be the third meeting between these two pairs. The last time they met was in the first round of the Australian Super Series, and it was the Malaysians who won on that occasion. It has to be said, and I don't want to take anything away from the Malaysians, but it does have to be said that Ahmad and Nasir had won their home Super Series event, the Indonesian Open. Then on the Monday, they had to fly to Sydney. They had to take the overnight flight, only arrived on the Tuesday, and they really had no time to adjust and get ready. But nonetheless, you have to give credit to the Malaysian pair winning that last encounter. Eric Kurt of Denmark is our umpire for this. And Emily Orushman from France is our service judge.
Play.
The Malaysian number 8 seats, Tan and Lai, getting this quarter final underway.
One love.
Yeah, nice block. Well, I say that Liliana Nasir is vastly experienced, and I think that's a bit of an understatement. Four-time world mixed doubles champion, twice with her partner of today, and twice with Nova Widianto, with whom she was actually in three world championship finals. So 7 medals from world championships in the mixed doubles discipline. Liliana Nasir. And she's one of only 2 players in badminton history to win 7 world championship medals in the same discipline. The only other player is Lin Dan in the men's singles. Oh, that's delightful.
3-2.
Makes such a difference to Ahmad when he takes the shuttle early. Good serve.
Top. Service over. 3-4.
That is extremely well taken.
4-3.
been very concerned about Liliana Nasir's right knee. She's got heavy strapping on it, plus a little band of support underneath the patella. Now her movements and her ability to change direction is in question. The more the Malaysians can try and exploit that, the better from their perspective. From the Indonesians' perspective. Well, Liliana Nasir is so good at reading the game, it's not often she's caught out of position. Pushed it wide.
Service over.
And that was a run of four straight points.
Six.
The Malaysian mixed doubles coach. She was actually beaten in the final here in the women's doubles in 2008, playing with Wong Pei Ti. She actually played a women's doubles title with the Malaysian on courts, Lai Pei Jing. And that, they won the Malaysian International Challenge. It's their only tournament together. That's well taken off
Five,
the top of the table.
Seven.
Oh, good defense. Overdone it.
Service over. 8-6.
Oh, well, there's the struggle with the movement from Liliana Nasir.
10-6.
That was a nice idea.
7-10.
Yeah. So the body movement of Tontoi Akma going backwards in court. Thank you.
Brilliant. Oh, there's a challenge.
Tan Kian Meng challenges. Called in.
Well, it wasn't the centre line we were looking at. No, what's happened there? Here we go. Yeah, plumb on the line.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. 8-10. Play.
Clever. Yeah, very, very clever from Tan Kian Meng.
11-8.
And it is the Malaysian number 8 seeds that have the advantage, a 3-point advantage here at the mid-game interval of the opening game. Well, I suspect there's something about the defensive play there.
Ten. Could you put the towel down, please?
He was caught way out of position, wasn't he? That was the final rally before the mid-game interval.
Liliana to receive. 11-8. Play.
It's gone long. She has this uncanny ability to be in the right place at the right time. Reads the game so well, Liliana Nasir. That's a great smash.
Service over. 9-12.
Great angle and great accuracy. Oh, that was a very dangerous shot from Tuntui Ahmad.
10-12.
Playing the cross court clear to Tan Kian Meng. Good return.
Service over.
Yeah, just a fraction too much pace on it for Liliana Nasir to reach. And not nearly enough pace on it for it to go through to Tuntui Ahmad. Really is an ideal shot in all doubles disciplines, that little mid-court shot, especially when it's aimed towards the tram lines.
Thank you.
Oh, clever. Yeah. It was a little hold and flick over the head of Tontowi Ahmad. Well, it did all the damage there.
11.
That one. Brilliantly played.
Just told.
Well, he'd worked the rally so well. Ahmad then made the error on what should have been the winning shot.
Okay. Tontowi, if you want to change, tell us immediately. Quickly, if you want to change, not wait.
Well, the umpire, Eric Kurt from Denmark, just saying to Ahmad, if you want to change the shuttle, you've got to say so immediately. Good umpiring. Just wastes a little more time after a wander around the court and everything that goes on, and then you say you want the shuttle changed.
Service over. 12. 15.
She's also the only player to contest two Olympic mixed doubles finals. Liliana Nasir. Silver medalist in Beijing. With Nova Widianto, and then obviously gold medalist last year with her partner of today. Wide.
13-15.
She's ready to pounce, and I think that's just perhaps provoking Ahmad into error. Look, she's hovering. Yeah. Knew he had to make it perfect. No margin for error. Oh, yes. Big, big gap. That was well found.
15,
I know the opportunity
16.
Was there after a mess up on the return of serve, but even so, it was well found. For the slice smash, overdoing it.
Seventeen,
This is a big, big point. Yeah, Tuntoi Akman knew it. He pounced on the low serve.
16-17.
I think that goes down as another missed opportunity from Tuntoi.
18-16. Nats here to receive.
Oh, my goodness. Well, one came back that I really didn't expect. I'm not sure the players did either. This one. And got it back with a net court.
17-18.
Two-point advantage and 2 points from this opening game from the Malaysians. Oh, that's a good return of serve again.
Service over. 18-19.
Gives two game point opportunities to the Malaysians. One game point has come and gone. That's a good lift.
19-20.
This time, the Malaysians convert. 21-19 in 23 minutes. Oh, on the world and Olympic champions were in a spot of bother. And there is Vita Morisa. Final rally of that opening game. Interesting dynamics to have the coach, a former women's doubles partner of Liliana Nasir. In fact, they reached three Super Series tournament finals, winning two of them as a women's doubles partnership. And of course, the coach is the player that Liliana Nasir beat with Nova Woodyanto in the final here 8 years ago.
20 seconds.
When Liliana Nasir won her first French Open title.
Malaysia.
Well, it's been 9 years since the last Malaysian pair reached a mixed doubles semi-final here. 2008, Khoo Kian Kiat and Wong Pei Ti were in the semi-final now. Tang Qiang Ming and Lai Pei Jing are one game away from emulating that and reaching at least the semi-final.
One love.
Very impressed with Lai Peijing in this match. She is apt, there she is, she's absolutely stood her ground at the net. Hasn't been afraid to take on Liliana Nasir. When a pair have gone through a bit of a shaky stage and their last four Super Series tournaments, the Malaysians have lost in either the first or the second round, and then suddenly when you find your form again, you really find your form again. Actually been in a semi-final for Super Series events. That was in Singapore earlier this year, but this is only their third Super Series quarter-final.
4-2.
And of course now, at this stage, when you're playing world and Olympic champions, all the pressure is on your opponents.
Four,
That's well taken from Liliana Nasir. Oh, clever. Oh, agonizingly close. It was the right shot to play. And look, the Indonesians were backing off from the net. Straight points. No wonder, is this the turning point? Just guided the shots across court into that open space. Into quick reactions too. This is six straight points now. Yeah, nice drop
shot.
Service
over. 5-8. Santori. Santori.
Morley umpire's going to have a word with Tantoi.
Don't squeeze the shuttle.
Well, the umpire thought that he was interfering with the shuttle by squeezing it. And that makes the shuttle fly a little bit quicker. Good return.
Service over. 9-5.
Good judgment. Eight of the last 9 points. Good defense. Oh, it's just wide. I was about to say, what a brilliant shot. But it is the former champions that go to the big game interval, having won 9 of the last 10 points. with a 6-point advantage.
To serve. 11-5. Play.
Well, it looks as if we might be treated to a third and deciding game. I wasn't convinced by that at the start of this second game when the Indonesians were 2-4 down. You should never write off world and Olympic champions, especially when one of them is Liliana Nasir. Such a clever player. Beautiful. I think it was the hold and flick from Liliana Nasir deep into the forehand corner that did the damage.
16-6.
This one. Yeah. Over the last 17 points. Oh, what a smash.
Service
goodness me. Leapt in the air, created a wonderful angle. Tan Kiang Meng. Look at that.
17.
Being asked to move the full width of the court at the net, struggling to do so. Way in. My goodness me, what on earth was she thinking?
9-17.
Well, in badminton terms, that wasn't particularly close. Oh, delightful. Not only a wonderfully accurate disguised drop shot, but the vision to see that's where the gap was. That was tremendous. Beautiful. Well, one suspects they've left it too late to come back in this second game, the losing pair, but you just never know. Five straight points. A couple more, and then there'll be real belief they can come back. There's another one.
12-17.
Oh, delightful again. She just can't move. Nasir cannot push off or lunge on that right leg. Well, it really is believable now, isn't it? Only 4 points in it.
13-17.
There were 11 points adrift a moment ago. Don't believe it. How did she get that back? Yeah. That one. How did she get that back? Yeah, that one bounced first. You're not allowed to do that. I mean, her partner helped it over. But that defensive shot was amazing. Australia of the match so far as well. Gone wide. 2 points away from this second game now. The former 19, champions.
14.
one point away. Very, very good serve.
Game point, 14.
Yep. One game all. 21-14, the second game. In favour of the number four seeds, Tom Toy and Liliana Nasir.
One game all.
One game all confirms the umpire. Forty-four minutes into the match. And we will have a third and deciding game. Talking about crossing at the net there. Well, the Malaysian pair have got to keep themselves together mentally.
One love.
Because I think that the Indonesians are great front runners. Yeah. Well worked.
Two love. 10.
No live paging, wanted the shuttle changed. Indonesians happy to oblige. Very level backswing with the racket there. Short, sharp motion of the racket head from Lai Peijing. Watch this. Yep. Very sharp.
Play.
Very, very good defence. What was it I was saying during the interval between the second and the third game? I thought that coach Chin Yi Hui was telling her players to cross. Well, it wasn't just at the net.
Thank you.
lucky net cord, but she earned her own luck there, taking it early. Such a good smash. Yeah, lift was a bit short, wasn't it? You can always tell by where the player's smashing from, where their feet are, as to how deep the lift has been.
Service over. 6-5.
It's always effective, isn't it? Those little pushes down to the tram line. Half court shot.
Service over. 6-6. Play.
Yeah, she really has been brave at the front of the court, Lai Peijing. She had to defend. She moved forward, prepared to take Liliana Nasir on. There she is, playing back to the net. Very, very good play indeed. First time in this deciding game. Malaysians in the lead. Oh, goodness gracious. That would have hurt.
Service over.
Yeah. Into the right shoulder blade.
7-7. Yeah.
Oof, yeah. Yeah, you can see him cringing at the same time.
Service over. 8-7.
brilliant. Straight down the line. There wasn't much of a gap there, I can assure you. That's nigh on perfect.
Service over. 8-9.
Want to get involved in those flat-fast exchanges with Tantowi Atman moving further and further towards the net. Well, that's suicidal. He's very, very good at those. One game all, 9-0.
Service over.
Nine. Oh, good placement with the smash.
Service over.
Aim towards the left hip.
10-4.
Wei Peijing was waiting, committed to the forehand defense. Look at this. She's looking towards the forehand side. Oh, this is earlier on. There. There we go. Good awareness from Atman.
Oh!
Don't believe it. What a dive. Still the rally goes on. Athletic dive from Tantowi Atman. Look at this. Here he goes, full strength, stretch. Still in the rally. Yeah, he slipped quite away. Dive was all worth it because it means they have the advantage, just 1 point advantage. And the change of ends.
Play. Oh. Service over. 11-all. 11. Service over. 12-12.
Say what a wonderful return of serve net shot from Liliana. Tang Qiangming. But it was even better.
13-12.
Now see it, look at that. Well, she's made the difference in the last two rallies.
14-12.
Four straight points, and all of a sudden, it's got a different feel to it. A very different feel to it, this deciding game.
16-12.
People often say, what does experience mean? What difference does it make in a match? Well, I think we've just seen it right here and now. Liliana Nasir's net shot has changed the whole momentum of this match.
17.
She's just 12. Stoked up the pace. She's made the difference rally after rally. And on a run of six straight points. There again, good net exchange. And there's another. It's this ability by the champions to suddenly sense
18,
what
12.
Are important rallies when they need to raise their level of play. And not only recognising when they need to do it, actually having the ability to do it. And it's really what defines great champions, I suppose. They're just running away with this now. Eight straight points.
19-12.
Perfect smash. Nine straight 20. Points. Now, eight match point opportunities. Well, that is amazing. 10 straight points from 11-12 down to 21-12 to close out the match in 1 hour and 3 minutes. Well, what a performance, especially from Liliana Nasir. From that 11-12 deficit, she was magnificent. But you always have to be backed up by your partner. You can never win alone.
Liliana Nasir, 19-21, 21-14, 21-12.
So the umpire just confirming that scoreline, 19-21, 21-14, 21-12 in the deciding game in 1 hour and 3 minutes. And they book their place in a third semi-final here at the French Open.
Well done. Well done. Thank you.
World and Olympic champions coming back after a game deficit there. Ahmad and Nasir to book their place in the semi-final. Next up is the second women's singles, and it features the current world number one, Tai Su Ying, up against the former world number one, Ratchanuk Intanon. Well, we already saw in our first quarterfinal of the day, Pusala Venkata Sindhu safely through in two straight games. That match, a repeat of the World Championship semi-final. What we're about to watch now is the top quarter of the draw, and it's a repeat of the All England final. And of course, it was Tai Su Ying, the world number one, who won on that occasion. Defending champion still in the women's singles, that's He Bingjiao, the left-hander from China. Two of the most talented players in world badminton.